Hopefully you've been following my heat pump installation journey. If not, then please do go and check out the other videos in the series. I've been documenting the whole process from start to finish. Well, as part of that process, I had to have some water tanks removed from my loft, which is where I am right now. The ceiling area under those tanks was not insulated, and that was to prevent the tanks from freezing up, so they'd be kept warm by the heat leaking from the house. Well, of course, now that they've gone, we really don't want any heat leaking out through the ceiling at all, because that's a waste of money and will slow down how quickly my house heats up. So my job today is to sort that out. I've got the TOPDON thermal imaging camera here, which I'm going to use to inspect all of my ceiling, not just where the tanks were, to find any gaps that I need to fill in. This is the TOPDON thermal imaging camera. It comes in a compact carry case with a lens cloth and an extension and adapter cable, depending on which model you have. This one here is the TC002, which has a lightning connector for use with iPhones. You can also get a USB-C version for Android phones, but with the lightning version you can request a free lightning to USB-C adapter cable, so as you can use it with newer iPhones and iPads too. I've got an iPhone 14 Pro and it just plugs really easily into the bottom, just like that. I've also tried it on an iPad Air 4 using the USB-C adapter cable, and it works just as well on that. You need to download the Top Infrared app to use the camera, and certainly when I plugged this into the iPhone, it popped up with a message that asked me to install it and open the App Store for me. So when you open the app, it's really easy to get started. You just tap on the thermal imaging mode in the middle of the screen, and you'll immediately get a picture of your own hand. Now, top tip from me here is take your phone, turn it upside down, and now your hand is no longer blocking the lens. So you can clearly see there, that's my camera right in front of me. Now you could use the extension cable that they provide, but I've actually found that you need two hands to use that, so it got a bit too tricky. Now, the first thing you'll probably do when you get one of these is take a selfie. Everyone does. And then you'll go walking around your house looking for warm things to point it at, like the nearest animal or family member. So go on, you'll need to spend a few minutes to get that out of your system before we can settle down to do some proper work. So there are two options in the app, photo or video. Do you want to shoot a video or do you want to take still photos? Well, that's up to you really, but you do need to be aware of the auto shutter feature, which is a necessary evil. Every few seconds the camera will click and the image will freeze. It's basically making sure it's still giving you accurate temperature readings. You can turn this off by tapping the three dots button and turning off auto shutter. Now you will need to remember to tap the manual shutter every now and then, or your readings may start to drift from reality. One more feature I want to mention before we go and start using it for real is the way it can merge the image from your phone's normal camera with the thermal camera. Now this can help you see what you're actually pointing at when things are all a similar temperature and the thermal image isn't showing any detail. You turn this on by tapping the little up arrow that's down at the bottom and then the little picture arrow, and then you need to tap dual light up at the top. There's some instructions there on the screen now, but then you have to kind of drag and resize your overlay image until it matches with the thermal imaging output. It's quite tricky to do at close sort of range, but I think you sort of get the idea. You can see my camera there and its thermal output underneath. Personally, I haven't found myself wanting to use this particular feature. Having to keep realigning the images is a bit of a pain, and I didn't find the images to be of any real benefit to me, even though they did look pretty cool. Right, anyway, that's enough playing around. It's time to go and put this to work. So I'm going to start here on my landing, which is where the loft hatch is, just up there. That's how we get into the loft, obviously. And then just as you get into the loft, there's some boards that run all the way up to where the tanks used to be. So let's use the camera and have a good look at what's going on there. So if I point at the loft hatch itself, you can see it's not too bad. It's pretty well insulated. Well, we've got a cold spot in the corner over there. That's showing up like a deep blue, same as the windows really, so that must need addressing. If I come back a bit, I can see some bars running across there. Those must be the joists in the loft. I don't think there's going to be much I can do about that because there's boards sitting right on top of them. If I turn around and look in the other direction, yeah, you can see the joists quite clearly. Not much I can do about that. Bit of a cold spot in that corner there above the stairs. And then this bit down here looks like along the edge of the wall might be a bit of missing insulation. So that's certainly first thing to have a look at. So now I'm in our bathroom, which is why it's gone a little bit echoey, I imagine, on the audio. And I know that there's going to be an issue here because the tanks were actually partially just above this ceiling here. So this is first time I've looked and it's going to be quite interesting. Let's point the camera up there. Ah, yeah, you can see big blue cold spots where there's no insulation at all. I tried to pull some insulation over just to cover it up a bit, but there's clearly a big gap and it goes all the way across there. Loads to sort there. Oh, all around there as well. That does surprise me. I don't know what that bit is, but that's definitely a big cold spot. And if I look at the rest of the ceiling, you can clearly see it's a shower. And there's a reflection of me in the window too. That's bizarre. Oh, you can see clearly there's water in the system. And oh look, okay, there's a big gap across there. That's against the wall. So that's an outside wall, so that needs looking at. And then the fan, the extractor fan, that's surprisingly warmer than everything else. So this is my bedroom and the airing cupboard is just on the other side of this wall here. That's where the hot water tank used to be. And there were loads of pipes running up the wall into the loft there. So I imagine there's gonna be a few issues just up here. So let's take a quick look. Oh, actually, surprisingly, there's not a lot there, but there are some gaps just here, running all the way along the house. Now, I think that's where there's a big beam that can't easily be insulated. Otherwise, I won't be able to walk across the loft properly. But we'll see when we get up there. Might be able to do something about that. Yeah, it runs the whole length. Oh, and then we've got some issues just over here. That's above the ensuite, which is there. So yeah, those need filling in. Ah, and loads of cold patches all the way along there, along the wall above the window. I don't know what I'm gonna be able to do about that actually. That's right on the edge where the roof comes down. It's really difficult to get to. It might involve crawling on some boards or something. So while I've got the camera out having a look for problems, I noticed that just on the wall here above my telly was a great big cold spot. And I assume that's the gas flue that's running from the fire that's now disconnected. You can sort of see a little bit of a cold spot poking out behind the speaker there. I assume it runs the whole height of this wall, probably upstairs too. I don't know what to do about that. So if anyone's got any suggestions on what I can do to insulate this gas flue, then please let me know in the comments. Okay, that's a very quick job for the moment, but I think that'll do. That's almost two rolls of insulation. So I'm gonna have a quick scan around with the camera now to look for hot spots. Now you can clearly see a little gap there where there's single insulation, but there's like there's a beam there that I need to be able to stand on in case I need to get to different parts. So kind of got to sacrifice a little bit of heat loss for convenience. Probably need to do a better job over there because, well, that's where the vents run for the ensuite. And round the back here, still quite warm there, bit of heat coming through. You can clearly see the difference between two layers and one layer of insulation. A few little heat spots coming through. underneath here. Oh, look, it's my handprint. That's really cool. Okay, underneath here, that's a lot better. I'm not seeing the hot spots come out from under there anymore. Okay, I'm pleased with that. See what it looks like downstairs. After all that effort and very itchy insulation, let's see if it was all worthwhile. Right, so that was as before, and there was a bit of a cold spot in this corner up here. There's still a little bit of a cold spot, but I think I've got that sorted. And if I turn around and look down the room, okay, we've still got a few cold spots there. I don't think I'm ever going to get rid of these joist cold spots, but I put insulation across where that join was there, where that wall is, so that seems to have improved it a little bit. Let's go and look in the bathroom. So here in the bathroom, there were three areas where I was going to try and improve the insulation. So the first one was along the ceiling here, between the, well, against the outside wall. And you can see it's slightly better than before. I think just there is where an A-frame comes down on the roof, so I'm not going to be able to do too much about that, but I'll have to go back up and have another look in a bit, I think. And then there was a cold spot around here. You can see there's a beam running across the ceiling, so I'm not going to be able to get that, I don't think. Okay, I might be able to improve it a bit. I put double insulation over the top of it as well. Maybe that'll improve over a few hours. And then up here, yeah, again, that's where the big tank frame was. And it's better than before. I think there's still room for improvement. I'm really going to have to stuff insulation underneath all of the frame to improve on that. And then lastly, I wanted to check above the ceiling in my bedroom. So we have a look up there where the tank was. I think there's still a few little gaps. That's along the walking plank, the beam that I need to walk on. So I covered it there a little bit because there is another beam for me to step on. So that's why that's a bit better there. But there's still this area here, and that is under where the tank was. So I've really got to go back up there and sort that out. I thought I'd got it all, but clearly I haven't. This is quite a useful tool to see where you're going wrong, I guess.
While I was walking around the house looking for cold spots, I did take a look at the cat flaps because they're obviously not very well insulated. The cat flap in my utility actually looks like it has devil horns through the thermal camera, and that's because the door it's on isn't flat. I've stuffed up the gaps with insulation and silicone sealed the top to make it neat. It probably won't make much of a difference, but every little helps. I also noticed that the door frame is really cold all along the edge. This isn't from the gap with the door, but actually between the wall and the door frame. I tried silicone sealing along the join, but I think I need to squirt some expanding foam insulation from the garage side, as the door frame has quite a gap around it. So this camera has many other uses, a number of which I'm not qualified to discuss really, such as checking to make sure electric circuits are safe and that sort of thing. It's interesting to go around the house and point the camera at different electrical items and wires to see what's getting hot. This is my solar inverter and battery, and you can clearly see the cables and components are a lot warmer than the surrounding walls. And if you're a plumber, then using it to look for heating pipes hidden in the walls is also going to be quite useful, I imagine. So look, I've found this camera extremely useful to help improve the heat loss of my home. I've fixed some issues that I was already aware of, and it's highlighted some things that I wasn't aware of too that I'll need to get sorted. You can get this camera from Amazon if you're interested. Maybe get one between a few households like your family or your neighbours, because it's the sort of thing you'll want to use a couple of times a year to keep an eye on things. So you'll want easy access to borrow it, but they're quite pricey, so sharing one is a great idea to maximise the number of people who benefit from it. I'll put an affiliate link down in the description, so please do go click on that if you decide to buy one. Please don't forget to like the video and subscribe to my channel to see more from me. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.